It was challenging, never boring. The big picture was one in which governments were supposedly doing all of this. But on the ground in New York, where we were, we're talking with people. People had to do this. And with very few exceptions, none of the people who were working at Cato had previously worked in a sort of collaborative team environment with people from the other countries. So it was a first experience for all of them. And one of the things we did early on, I decided that we were having a little trouble crossing cultural barriers. I mean, small things. For example, everyone would come to work in the morning and the Americans were all kind of ebullient and hail fellow well met. And they would say good morning to the Japanese and Koreans who were coming in, who couldn't understand why this greeting process was necessary every time we started a new work day. And so Americans were kind of drawing back, saying, well, they're not very friendly. And so I found a couple of cross-cultural trainers in New York and brought them in, and they began trying to work on all of these problems. And I think everyone had tremendous goodwill on all sides. Everybody wanted to make this happen and to make it truly collaborative and productive. But there were some of these cultural difficulties that, in retrospect, I think we worked our way through pretty successfully. And eventually we developed, my objective always was to develop a Cato spirit, a feeling that the enterprise we were trying to conduct jointly was larger than the individual interests of any of the governments concerned. And I think for the most part we pulled that off. We had to contend frequently with intrusions from capitals, but we quickly developed a sort of ethos in which we were united against capitals because they were the guys who were trying to screw us up.